Hello, Cloud Gurus, and welcome back to another AWS This Week, where we find out what goodies AWS have announced in the past 7 days. I am your friendly neighborhood Jess Alvarez, and this week, Amazon MSK has new low-cost virtually unlimited storage tier. AWS IoT Core now has location action. And finally, Amazon VPC now supports transfer of EIPs between accounts. Stay tuned to hear the full story in this episode of AWS This Week. Amazon Managed Streaming for Apache Kafka, or MSK, say that five times fast, is a fully managed service that allows customers to build and run applications that use Apache Kafka to process streaming data. MSK provides the ability to create, update, and delete clusters, as well as produce and consume data using open source versions of Apache Kafka. Which brings me to the brand new hype. Amazon MSK now offers tiered storage that scales to be virtually unlimited. Tiered storage allows customers to store and process data while cutting costs by 50% or more over existing MSK storage options, as well as providing a longer safety buffer that can handle unexpected processing delays or build new stream processing applications. This new storage option is enabled with a few clicks for new or existing clusters, and customers will pay for storage and data retrieval. Check out the resources for more documentation you can dive into. AWS Internet of Things Core is Amazon's fully managed service used to securely connect Internet of Things devices to the cloud. It does have a free tier and now has the capability to route latitude and longitude data from Internet of Things devices to Amazon location service. What does that mean? Well, this new functionality makes it easier for developers to add geospatial data and location functionality to your Internet of Things applications. AWS Internet of Things Core uses a feature called Rules Engine that filters, processes, and routes data to AWS and third-party services. Use the Location Action feature in Rules Engine to send location data to Amazon Location Service to track, record, and visualize Internet of Things devices. All of that sounds crazy complicated, huh? Well, lucky for you, there's a walkthrough video in the resources to show you exactly how to get this done. As of October 31st, Elastic IP addresses are now, drumroll please, transferable across AWS accounts. Elastic IP addresses are static public IP addresses designed for dynamic cloud computing, meaning you can attach and detach them to an instance or network interface in any VPC in your account. This helps customers quickly recover from situations like a downed instance, among several other scenarios. This new functionality will allow for easier restructuring across AWS accounts and migrations. Prior to this new functionality, you had to allocate new Elastic IPs for your applications, requiring an allow list listing the EIPs and your connectivity resources. This new functionality now eliminates that need to have an allow list for connectivity resources and accelerates migrations. For more information, take a look at the documentation in the resources. I hope you enjoyed this episode of AWS This Week. I'll include some links in the resources to cover all the fancy new things we covered today. Don't forget to join our awesome Discord community, where you can hang out with all of our AWS training architects and like-minded people. And if you're looking to get started in the cloud or boost your career, we're inviting you to get hashtag cloud happy. Until the end of the year, we're giving away free training for Amazon's Cloud Practitioner certification, Microsoft's AZ-900 Azure Fundamental Certification, and Google's Cloud Digital Leader Certification, as well as the HashiCorp Certified Terraform Associate and Certified Kubernetes Administrator Certs. So, if you're ready to get your head in the clouds, check out the link in the description to sign up for free and boost your cloud career now. Thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and we'll see you next time.